ओके वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू। इन दिस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द टेस्ट परफॉर्म्ड ऑन कोर्स एग्रीगेट। इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द टेस्ट एंड द प्रॉपर्टीज test performed on fine aggregate and the properties of the coarse aggregate. So next is the test on the coarse aggregate. The first test included determine the fineness modulus of an aggregate. The procedure is as shown. It required the apparatus is the sieve size as stated in the procedure, then weighing machine, pan and sieve shaker if it is available, or we can done the sieving by manually. First is go for the procedure. Point number first, take about 1 to 2 kg aggregate, that is coarse aggregate. Arrange the sieve in descending order such that the larger size sieve should be at the top and smaller size at the bottom. So in descending order we arrange the sieve like this. The sieve with maximum size or larger opening, it should be at the top, and with a smaller opening or small size should be at bottom. Last, it is covered by the pan. Next step, after getting the sample aggregate, place the aggregate sample in the top sieve and cover with the lid. We can place the aggregate into the top sieve and cover it with a lid. It is cover provided for the sieve. Next step, sieve the aggregate using the appropriate sizes of the sieves like 80 mm, 40 mm, 20 mm, 10 mm, 4.75 mm, 2.36 mm, 1.1 8 mm, 600 micron, 300 micron and 150 micron. That is for fineness modulus of the coarse aggregate. We required the sieve size 80 mm, 40 mm, 20 mm, 16 mm, 10 mm, 4.75 mm, 2.36 mm, 1.18 mm, 600 micron, 300 micron and 150 micron. So the 60 mm sieve size, if available we can use it, if not available we can use 20 and 10 mm also for the sieve analysis. The sieving is done either manually or by mechanically by use of the sieve shaker for at least 15 minutes. That is, if sieve shaker is available, then we arrange all the sieves in a sieve shaker. So like the fine aggregate, we arrange the sieves in this sieve shaker for sieving, and after starting the sieve shaker, we can sieve all the aggregate through the sieve shaker. Then record the weight of the aggregate written on the each sieve sides. Note down the weight of the aggregate written. After sieving by manually or by mechanically, we can get the aggregate which are written on the sieves and take a weight of this aggregate and note down in a grams. After weight is taken, that is retained weight of the aggregate on each sieve size, calculate percentage weight retained, and from this percentage weight retained, calculate cumulative weight of the aggregate retained on each sieve size, and calculate cumulative percentage of aggregate retained. That is, first we calculate weight of the aggregate, then percentage of the aggregate, and then after calculating the cumulative percentage of the aggregate retained, add the cumulative weight of the aggregate and divide this number by 100. Then the value obtained is the finest modulus of the aggregate. These steps we carry out during the practical work or during the problem solving. After this lecture, we go for the one of the example, that is how we can calculate the cumulative weight of the cumulative percentage of the aggregate, and from this how to determine the finest modulus of the aggregate by taking the weight retained on the each sieve size. So for coarse aggregate, we required the sieve size are 80 mm, 40 mm, 20 mm, 10 mm, 4.75 mm, 2.36 mm, 1.18 mm, 600 micron, 300 and 150 micron. Sometime if available, then we can use a 60 mm micron. In this, we add or take the cumulative addition up to 150 micron, and after taking the addition of the percentage retained up to 150 micron, we divide this cumulative percentage retained by number 100, which will give the finest modulus of the coarse aggregate. This is the arrangement of the sieve: top containing the larger size and bottom containing the, or last containing the smaller size with the pan. We take the weight of the aggregate from top to last, that is in the pan, so that after sieving we can make an addition of the all the aggregate written on the each sieve size, such that if the sample is taken 2 kg or 2000 gram, then the addition of the aggregate retained on each sieve size up to the pan should be meet the value, that is the value of the sample taken 2 kg or 200 gram. So we require to take the weight in a pan to check the weight of the sample and weight of the aggregate retained in the sieves. But for calculation, we use the weight of the aggregate retained on sieve up to 150 micron. So this is about the finest modulus of the coarse aggregate. So we can see the other test like crushing value, impact value in our next lecture. So thank you for joining us. Thank you.